Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this matchup between the Seahawks and the 49ers. So often we talk about the quarterback matchup, but when you have a stud running back like we have here today, what do you think we're going to see here?
Well, we know this. He's going to get his carries, and rightly so. He has earned them, and you do that through breaking tackles, picking the right hole to run through, and this running back has done that. On the other side, he just hopes to get as many chances, and you get those chances. They're going to give you a few, but if you don't make it happen early, you won't get any more.
He's brought to a halt. They'll take it at the 20. Down as they head to the line, running to the right. He's brought down at the 25-yard line.
That was a nice run that time by the offense, picking up those yards. And anytime you gain more than 3 yards on a running play in the National Football League, it is deemed successful.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. In on the stop.
When a coach can have a run that picks up those kind of yards, it gives them confidence, and they will show more and more patience with the running game, so the defense, they better dig in here.
First down and 10. The pass is intercepted. He stacked up at that point.
Well, that's a rough way to get the game started, isn't it, Phil? Come out and throw an early pick.
Oh, it is. It's a terrible way to start for the quarterback and everybody involved, but I'll tell you this, I think it was a terrible call. So the quarterback, when the play's not there, throw it away. He took a chance, and that's why it was intercepted.
On first down. Quarterback, quick toss to the outside. Touchdown, Seahawks.
You don't see a lot of them anymore because we have so many good tackling safeties in the NFL, but not this time. That long run goes for a touchdown. It was about the moves and the blocks down the field. Terrific job by the offense.
The point after try is in the books. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. And a touchback. Lined up in the pistol formation. LaMichael James. Now, cutting to the right side, looking for some open space.
I know they want to come out and establish the run, but, boy, this defense right now is not bending.
They're doing a good job so far, the defense, but on the offensive side, stay patient, keep pounding that football, and hopefully you can wear this defense down as the game goes along.
Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Of course, it's a three and out.
I got to blame the offensive line that time. Giving up a sack early in a game like that, you cannot take chances. Don't overplay as an offensive lineman. If you do it, you give up a sack.
Tackles made.
When you get an opportunity like this, you want to take advantage of it. The defense did. The opportunity was there. They get a chance to intercept the football. They do. Now, can their offense take advantage of this situation?
They come to the line, and it's first down. Here's the quick toss. Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
Well, that looks like an upper body injury, Jim. I think we both can tell that. And now the question is, how bad is it? You just never know.
Second down now. The tackle is made at the 40-yard line. It's third down coming up.
As they go ground here, gain of 8.
Excellent job of just picking up the first down. This offense is hot. Another first down, and they are moving down the field.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Quarterback drops back, play action. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
Another play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Second down, even after the completion.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, Jim, they didn't pull the defense at all. Second down, you run the football, hoping to make it third and short. Then you lose yards, third longs. They're hard to get in the NFL.
Third down, following the run.
Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. Makes the catch in open space.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
The Seahawks getting set to attempt the field goal.
Well, the defense is going to be excited. They come out there. The offense has great field position, but they stop them. But they give up 3 points, but still a victory for the defense.
That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. Manningham's lined up now as a slot receiver.
The wide receiver shifting around in motion.
He'll fire it out to the left, and that ball's nearly picked off, but he dropped it.
Well, when there's man-to-man coverage on the defensive side, and the defense does a job like this where they are covering those receivers, there is nothing a quarterback can do except that. Oh, another incomplete pass.
LaMichael James gets the carry.
The defense looking for one more stop here on third down after that run.
That catch good for a first down. Breaks the tackle.
It's got some daylight.
Fights off the hit. Touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
Terrible job by the defense. Lack of hustle, bad tackling, you name it. They allowed the short throw and catch to go all the way down the field for a score.
And he begins his return. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. First down here. Screen. The pass complete. In the books. Touchdown.
When you got a lead, you march down the field and you add on to that lead with a touchdown, it's fun to watch the other team. Will they stay patient or will they panic? My bet is they'll panic.
Makes the PAT. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Got the hand up into the sky, and that means fair catch.
Ohio! Ohio!
First down on the way. James gonna take the handoff now.
Boy, after watching that long run, I'm winded. That was a nice job by the running back. Good job up front, sustaining the blocks. Offense has got to be happy with that.
Here
Here they come back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play.
Running backs who can pick up extra yards, they are so valuable. You can't always block everybody to the ground. The running back's got to do it himself sometimes. Nice job there by the running back.
Ohio! Ohio!
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. And he's almost intercepted. Offense lines up here, and James has got it on the handoff. There's the tackle, but still, it's enough for the first down.
Anytime you picked up a couple first downs, here's what happens. The defense starts to doubt what they're doing, but maybe more importantly, it gets those big boys over there tired.
No way that would be completed.
When you play man-to-man coverage, it takes a good throw and catch. That time, neither was there. Another incomplete pass.
Wide receivers are bunched up, looking to the right side and throwing, and throws it incomplete.
Anytime your receiver running any route to the inside of the NFL, they're worried about getting hit. Don't lead them too far in a slant route. Just throw it right at them.
LaMichael James is in the backfield.
There's some shifting around in the backfield.
Third and 10. Running away from the pressure. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Good, solid tackle. Short of the first. And now we've got a fourth down situation. Offense lines up here. Throws to the right. Kaepernick hits Crabtree with that pass.
This is where games are won and lost. Once an offense gets down the red zone, even though they're down more than seven, can you find a way to punch it in there for the touchdown and not settle for a field goal?
Running to his right. Touchdown. This game is tight.
I would bet first and goal that the offense, about 90% of the time, is going to run the football. And what do they do here? They run it, and they get it done. That is power football at its best.
So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line. First down here. The handoff running behind the tackle. He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line.
Well, a short gain on the run that time by the offense. When you're a running football team, listen, there's going to be a lot of ugly plays that don't work. You just got to keep running it.
After being stuffed at the line of scrimmage, it's now second down and 10. Bringing the play to an end.
There wasn't much there that time, so good job by the quarterback just throwing the ball and getting the catch and just getting a couple yards.
Third down after the completion. This is a screen play all the way. The tackle was made, but the first down is picked up.
Terrible job that time by the defense. My gosh, you got the offense at third down. You let them throw a screen pass, you can't make the tackle, and you give up the first down.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Wilson from the shotgun, challenging the defense. Interception.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
First and 10. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Good job by the defensive player squaring up that running back and just putting his big butt right into the ground.
And now they'll try over again on second down. And he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
What a good job by the defensive player there, just flushing the running back and driving into the ground.
Going across the middle, gains 13.
Well, if you want to be a good play-action pass team, it's always nice to have a good running game. make the defense dig in and try to stop your run. When they do that, you fool them. You fake it, you throw it down the field. That's about as easy as it gets.
Jim, they got momentum on their side right now. They are making everything work. That was a nice play. They pick up another first down, and they got a good
It's a touchdown.
Ah, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there, and it's first and goal. If you score, now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if he gets the third down? You don't have to worry about it. Good run. Nice touchdown.
49ers setting up for the kickoff. At the 18-yard line. Now on first down. The give. Hey, up the middle. For the score, touchdown.
To me, still one of the most exciting plays in NFL football, a long running play for a touchdown. And how about that one? It had it all in its speed, good moves, good blocks, exciting touchdown.
Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. About the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. And now we reach the two-minute warning here in the second quarter. Offense lines up here. They'll go ground to the right side.
You know, when the linebackers, when they see that the offensive formation is shifting to one side, well, as a linebacker, you've got to play to that strong side and try to get up there and stop the run.
Michael James is in the backfield, and they go back to the ground. It's Earl Thomas who makes the tackle.
When you're going against a really athletic defense, there's nothing like reverses and the counter run game, because they see it, they go, and you counter it, and that's why it works to perfection.
When you have a defense that's not playing good techniques, they're selling out, overplaying plays. Well, you run the counter runs to counteract what they're doing on the defensive side.
First down here after the run. Frank Gore gets it here.
Gets it out to the 22.
When you talk about counter runs, what we just saw that time, the defense thinks the play's going one way, then a pulling guard or tackle comes around and catches a defensive lineman off guard and makes a good block.
Searching for space to the right. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Offside.
He was trying to get an early jump on the play, but the referee caught him in the neutral zone.
What a job by the offensive line that time. This running back hit the hole at full speed, and the defense had very little time to react. And that's how he got in the second.
Power serve for six. Touchdown.
That was just an awful job, wasn't it, by the defense? I mean, it's first and goal. Well, you know it's going to be a run, or I think you should be playing run. The defense not ready. They get overpowered, and they give up the running touchdown.
A takeaway. How much does this sting? They get the touchdown, but Phil, they fail to get the two.
Jim, I think it takes a lot away from the football team. It's a terrible decision. Now we'll find out if that 1 point comes back to haunt them.
Fakes out the defender right there on the spot. First down, offense readying for the snap. Into the open flat. That pass was hurried. After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
Setting up screen.
He has the grab. They break through. Tackle him behind the line.
The defense has really done a good job here in this drive. They got this offense in a third and long situation. Let's see if they can convert it.
So they get the reception, but it's not enough to move the chains. Third down coming up.
Got a big lane. Lynch with an impressive run.
Well, when you run the football on third and long on the offensive side, if it doesn't work, it is ugly. And we will sit here, guys like you and me, Jim, we'll second-guess the play call. But that time it was good, and they barely pick up the first down on the run.
First and 10. Lynch has got the carry once more. The Seahawks use another timeout here, and they have one left.
That's second down coming up.
Still running off the toss.
In these type of situations, when you're losing the game, it's third and long. Don't try to be a hero. Because when you try to be a hero, it's going to lead to a turnover. Then you really will be in trouble.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up.
They're setting up screen. And he's going to be tackled. And that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything. And it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time. A good call by the offense. They took the knee there. That's what I would have done too. That's the right decision. Go in at halftime, make some adjustments, and come out here and try to get it done in the second half.
Ohio! 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 Ohio!
James in the slot, not in the backfield for this play. First and 10. Toss to the outside. He steps out.
Well, the long run that time, and there's a lot of reasons why they got that long run. But the biggest one, the good blocking up front, but what patience for the running back. He did not panic because it took a while for that running lane to develop. But it did. He saw it. He hit it. And he used his talents to get down the field for the big game.
The 49ers signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining.
This will probably be the last play of the first half.
First and 10. Running it like it's an option play. Good piece of tackling.
So that's going to do it for the first half. 49ers are up in this one. We're back here now in this one where the 49ers lead by 5.
Let's check in on the sidelines. Danielle Fellini is there.
Guys, I got a chance to quickly speak with Bobby Wagner during halftime. His team is trailing up to this point, but he thinks his defense can turn this thing around, guys. He said, we just need to create opportunities for our offense, whether that's turnovers or good field position. If we do that, we can come back. That's all for now, guys. Back to you.
Danielle, thank you very much. Now we'll go to the field. Offense lines up here. The third quarter begins with this play. That brings the play to an end.
It's a dime look for the defense on this play.
Second and 5. Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch.
This play just takes so long. That's why it doesn't work too often in the NFL. Fast defenses. The quarterback makes the fake. He tosses the football outside to the runner. Nowhere to go, and he loses yards on the play.
Third down following the run.
Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside. The tackle was made short of the first, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Offense lines up here.
crosses it to the running back.
They fail to convert, and now a change of possession.
Terrible game management that time by the coach. It's three downs, it's fourth down. What should you do? I think you should punt it. He goes for it and puts his defense in a tough position.
Well, Michael James breaks free, has some space to work with. 49ers in the end zone.
How about the blocking up front? Lets the running back get in the secondary, and he is so quick and elusive, he avoids the tackles and takes it all the way for the touchdown.
Oh, it's a fake. Scrambling out of the pocket. So they give up the touchdown, but they do not allow the two-point play.
Yeah, good job that time by the defense. So quick and so ready for that play. They reacted very fast. That's why they stopped it.
Turn ends rather quietly, short of the 20. Let's mark him at the 16. They come out in a dime package. Set up screen.
Ah, the defense got away with one that time. It wasn't a good play on their part. It was just bad timing by the quarterback and receiver.
Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a 49ers official. Colt McCoy's injury seems to be relatively minor, or at least it's minor enough that he'll be back on the field shortly.
That last play made by Patrick Willis.
Russell Wilson is so quick. Hard to get a good shot on him. Every time he runs the football, he knows to get to the ground just before the big hit comes.
Loading up with extra defensive backs in the dime. Gets away from the pressure for a gain of about five.
I like this. Show some patience. Don't try to get it all one play. Pick up first downs and try to go down the field and score.
Defense comes out of the dime. Wilson still has it after some nifty play action. Could have been intercepted. The 49ers sat at the line. Dime package.
Second and 10.
Wilson's play action.
Almost intercepted.
That time, the man-to-man coverage won. The quarterback had to make a perfect throw. He didn't. Incomplete pass.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. That's been the story of this game. Another third down conversion to move the chains. New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground.
Straight ahead.
Touchdown and drawing close.
Now you know why running backs get drafted high. Because these long running plays for touchdowns, that's what you want. That's what the NFL is about. Making big plays, and when you get them in the running game, that's like double good.
Lining up now for the two. Could have taken the one-point gimme. They went for the two, and they are turned away. Seahawks ready here for the kickoff. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. First and 10. LaMichael James gets the carry to the right side. He's got room. That'll stop the play right there.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
They're able to move the chains after that last run.
Up ahead for about four.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they come up with a play that fools the defense.
Back to the ground. Gain of two.
Good job by the defense that time. Everybody's expecting a pass. They were ready for the run, and they stopped the offense for a short gain in the red zone.
This is third down. Gets it again here. They jam it in on the goal line. Touchdown.
This offense, they are so aggressive. I love it, man. Even though they had the lead, they kept pressing the issue, and they got another touchdown to increase that lead.
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. Point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The 49ers will come out in the dime. First and 10. Lynch going to lose yards here.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
And here we have second down. Middle. He'll be brought down, but not before picking up the first down.
When you play against a quarterback who likes to break the pocket and run down the field and pick up those yards, you got to be able to put a spy on. Put an extra defender in the middle of the field, watch the quarterback, and he moves left, you go with him and stop him from running out of the pocket. You got to keep your offensive lineman aggressive, so you have to run the football every once in a while. That run, even though it was a short game, it served a purpose.
They pounce on him there.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
He gets it again on this drive.
You're near midfield, it's fourth down. What do you do? I got the answer right here. You punt it. Play field position, make the other offense drive the length of the field to score.
Right back to him one more time. This doesn't look good. We've got a player down, and he's in pain.
Always hard to guess what the injury is, but I don't like to speculate, but I think it's pretty apparent. It's an upper body injury. We'll let you know when we find out. Running backs, they love counter runs. They know when a defense has been over-pursuing, so they make that fake one way, and when they cut it back, there's usually a great running lane there. That's where you need the big size on your defense. You need it inside. In other words, you need big defensive linemen that can cover the center and the guards to stop these runs right up the middle. What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
He's going to be swallowed up behind the line. That wraps up the third quarter here in one of the world's greatest cities, San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the fourth. To that last run, it sets up third and six. Gets away from the pressure, looking for a receiver on the left side here.
It's not all about speed at the quarterback position, running away from trouble. You're able to take a couple steps up, a couple steps sideways, get that extra time, avoid the sack, and still throw the football.
Michael James is in the backfield. Looking for an open receiver on the right. Touchdown, San Francisco.
I give all the credit to the wide receiver here. What a route. Pulled the defender. He is wide open. Nice throw by the quarterback for the touchdown.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff.
tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Offense lines up here. Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Gains 15.
Sometimes it's good protection by the offensive line. Sometimes it's just bad defense. They can't get to the quarterback, and that's another completion by them.
They've got a first down now after that catch.
Under pressure and incomplete.
Marshawn Lynch is in the backfield.
Escaping the pressure. The defense gets the sack.
Well, you see it all the time. When the offensive line can't stop the defensive pass rush, then you have your running backs hit a defensive lineman before they go out for the pass.
The offensive line gets in position. Can they protect their quarterback?
Backed up into third and 15. Looking for Percy Harvin. He has the ball deep down the field.
Well, even though they're down more than seven here, the offense down the red zone, it'll be good for them for the rest of this game. Their confidence for the offensive coach that they can punch this in for the touchdown.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Sticks to his hands.
Always a good job to pick up some yards when you're in the red zone. Nice throw by the quarterback, and he gets the completion.
Second down here.
The quarterback will hand it off. A tackle behind the line.
Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players. Your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back, they need to make a big play here.
Third down here. Offense trying to pick up the first.
Throws the pass. Incompletion on that hurried throw.
A short field goal try on the way.
And he puts it through for three.
That's just some bad play calling there at the end, Jim. It was a beautiful drive down the field by the offense, but they should have paid it off with 7 points. Bad calls. The offense can't overcome it, but the kicker comes through and at least gets some 3 points.
James is in the backfield. Takes it on the counter.
Your determination. What a run. Touchdown.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block and a long touchdown run.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Takes the snap from the shotgun. And so they convert it here on the two-point try. 49ers setting up for the kickoff. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Harvin's in the slot. He'll take the snap about midway through the fourth. Reaches out and grabs it. He's brought down at the 30-yard line.
I think the best thing to say about that play, it's just it gained a few yards, so that's what you do. All plays don't score. Sometimes you just want to pick up a couple yards.
Miller's playing out of position in the backfield here.
Caught. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, we see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Third down now.
2 minutes remaining, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one.
Third and four. Looking for Percy Harvin.
There's a receiver there, and the catch is made. Touchdown, and they cut it to that lead.
Well, that's a good touchdown by the offense there. And, you know, and what it's done, it's gotten this game closer. Gives them confidence, and confidence is a dangerous thing. We'll see if they can keep moving forward after this.
Extra point is good. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. Fair catch this time for a touchback.
Ohio! Ohio! Ohio!
And Manningham's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Has the first down and a whole lot more.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
The offense back to the line after the 60-yard gainer on the previous play. And that's enough for a first down.
Well, that's just a good old physical run by the offense here. And it's good for a few yards. It gets him another first down.
First down here after the run. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
After being stuffed at the line of scrimmage, it's now second down and 10. Ball's going to be incomplete. The hit knocked the ball out.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
That last pass incomplete, and it brings up third down.
They deck him in the backfield.
That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
This is it for Tazit. Touchdown.
This is why a head coach gets paid so much money. You get in situations like this, they have to make the call on fourth and goal. He goes for it, and they get it.
The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. Nice tackle. A ton of defensive backs out here for this play.
Looking for Percy Harvin. Intercepted.
Jim, this defense is just attacking today. They got the offense backed up. They go after them. They're aggressive. And what does it do for them? It gets them an interception inside the opponent's 20-yard line.
Andy Lee will be punting this one. No return. The ball's coming out to the 20. They face first down.
Looking for Percy Harvin. And he's intercepted.
They've got him down there.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
Let's roll! Let's roll!
And Manningham's a receiver in the slot. The formation here, shotgun.
it's incomplete.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
They're set to punt it away now.
Send it to the 20-yard line.
Harvin's lined up in the slot.
First and 10.
Got a little screen set up here.
And a flag comes out.
Grabbing the face mask. We see it almost once a week, and here it happens again.
Well, a lot of times these defenders, I'll give them a, you know, a little slack because they're running so fast. They're trying to tackle some tremendous athletes in open space, and sometimes accidentally you're going to grab the face mask.
Getting sacked.
Man, this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job. Makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
Defense comes to the line, ready to pounce on that quarterback one more time. Can they get another sack? Dante Whitner picks off that pass. The tackle was made.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
First and 10. And James is going to secure the handoff. He's got some daylight. That's it. This game is over. How much sweeter is practice going to be this week after the win on that